guys, welcome to the Tone Show. My name is Anthony Tone Show Nunez, and today we're talking about Van Helsing, Season 2, Episode 4, A Home. Okay, guys, so this episode is called A Home, and it's quite fitting, right? Because Vanessa just lost her home. Vanessa just lost her daughter, Dylan. Dylan was Vanessa's compass. She was her motivation, her MO, her home on this show. So right now, Vanessa is homeless. She's basically roaming aimless in this episode. She's just killing vampires. She's working through the madness, the anger. She doesn't know what she wants, and she's just basically going back to her instincts. And what she's good at? Killing vampires. And she calls it a cleanse. I would call it a binge. But Julius is basically the reason in this episode. He's the voice of reason for Vanessa. That's what he's become. And he basically is calling it a rampage. And I think Julius is right. Vanessa right now is going on a rampage, y'all. She's just getting her hands on any vampire she can, and she's going Hacksaw Jim Duggan on them with her axe, right? So Vanessa's just pissed off. And it was kind of rewarding when she punched Julius, because come on, remember who Julius was. And I think it's really interesting how the writers and the production on this show has just taken a turn with Julius. And Julius went from basically being a psychopath and a general for Dimitri to now he's like Vanessa's guardian angel. But more like the angel that sits on the right, the good angel. And Vanessa right now is just listening to her left, which is the evil vampire angel, right? So Julius is trying to guide Vanessa in a good path, and Vanessa's not hearing it. She's just mad. She just lost Dylan. She can't stand anything at this point, and punching is all she understands. So I thought it was really cool. Vanessa told Julius, I'm done running, right? When Julius tells him that these vampires, they basically came upon two people who were strung and skinned and were hanging from a tree. Julius tells Vanessa, this doesn't look like the work of regular vampires. And he tells her there's stronger vampires out there. And Vanessa basically turns to him and tells him, hey, I don't run anymore. Like, Vanessa's not playing, y'all. She's pissed off and she's not taking it anymore, right? So when they come upon these vampires, Julius is like, run. And Vanessa follows him, which she shouldn't have, right? And she gets knocked out and they get captured. And the minute she got captured, I thought they were gonna kill Julius or injure him badly, but that's not what happens. Basically, this little kid runs into the camp, and this kid distracts those kinky leather faced vampires who are wearing people's skin, right? Just gross. And they follow the kid, and of course Vanessa breaks free because Vanessa's super strong, right? So Vanessa basically finds the remaining vampire alive because they ran into this group called the Johnsons. And it's really interesting because the episode's called The Home, and this group, the Johnsons, basically they've created a home for these children because it's basically an apocalypse and there's children everywhere. There's parentless children running around, and they made it a home for these kids. And Vanessa, she's very... He's very cynical. She doesn't believe anything. She just lost Dylan, and she's just basically in her anger. So she's looking around for a villain, even if there's no villain to be presented at this camp. And when she sees the scars on Troy's hand, that young man's hand, she basically thinks, hey, there's something wrong that's happening at this camp, and I'm going to find out what it is. Meanwhile, Sam is back at the juvenile detention hall, and he's having a buffet, y'all. He's going finger madness. He's having finger food, and I mean real fingers. Like, he's back to his old ways of cutting people's fingers, and he's making himself some jewelry, like straight out of Jared's, right? But with fingers, really creepy. So Sam, in this show, he's also looking, in this particular episode, he's also looking for connection. He's looking for a home, and his home, he thinks, is Muhammad. Remember, Muhammad and Sam, they shared something before Muhammad found out that he was a psychopath and a serial killer, right? So Sam is looking for that connection. Even though he's a vampire now, he still misses Muhammad. And it's clear because he's taken this Felix character and he sees Muhammad in this character. And he's basically calling him my Muhammad, right? And he's trying to turn Felix into Muhammad. And Felix doesn't know what the hell's happening. He's been captured by this vampire. At one point, we think that Felix might be actually going to work with him. And then it turns out that he's not going to work with him. And Felix is just trying to escape. And when he thinks that he caged them off, right? And remember how Sam is moving throughout the day is that he has his whole costume. He looks like an owl man, right? He has his whole ninja costume that he's wearing. And that's how he's able to move through the day because he's not immune to daylight. Felix leaves him outside and he thinks, hey, I have him trapped. And he runs in and we see his real motivation. He doesn't want to be friends with Sam. He just wants to get away. He's playing coy on this one. And when he gets back in, he tries to free his fellow juveniles, right? From their prison that Sam has him in. And that's when Sam realizes that he's not Muhammad, Well, he's not the Muhammad he wants yet. He has to break him in. And what does that mean? He takes his actual tongue, guys. He cuts his tongue off and he makes himself a nice tongue bracelet with some fingers, right? Just creepy. So Sam is definitely back to his psychopathic ways. He's looking for connection. That's what this means. He wants connection. And he sees Felix and he sees Muhammad. He keeps calling him my Muhammad. How more clear can it get, right? Poor Felix doesn't know who Muhammad is and he just tries to get away. So is Felix still going to be on this show? I don't know. He's missing a tongue right now. So it looks really bad for Felix. Let's go back to the doctor and Axel. They're just roaming through the woods, basically, still looking for Vanessa because Vanessa's bike can hopefully bring Axel back to humanity. And these two, they're just being themselves, right? The doc is being the doc and Axel's being Axel. And we see now how Axel's managed not to kill anyone. He's basically been tying himself up in some type of kinky rope thing. And I'm assuming the little girl Carly was roping him before because how could he rope himself, right? So he asked the doc basically to tie him up because he wants to hold on to his humanity. And that's how you can tell that Axel's a good character in this whole apocalypse situation, that he still doesn't want to succumb to the hunger that he feels as a vampire. So that's why he asked the doc to tie them up. Looks like there wasn't much progress with those two. That's all we saw in this episode. The episode was basically about Vanessa, and again, it was about Sam finding a home. And it looks like Vanessa is going to be finding a home and kicking some ass, right? Because it turns out that the Johnsons have actually been meeting with the juveniles, and that Troy, that youngster who had the scar in his hand, he got that scar because those juveniles, remember, they have this whole thing about punishment. So they have Felix with his arms extended like this and they were whipping him. That's why when Sam was whooping that juvenile kid that he took out of his prison, right? And he was whooping him. It was basically to try to get Felix to like him and basically say, hey, look, they did this to you. I'm going to do this to them. You and me are together, right? We're together on this. So it was a cool turn. I didn't see that coming. The fact that the Johnsons, the group that Vanessa just met, have actually been trading all along with the juvenile detention group. And Vanessa basically, the minute she sees the bodies, and specifically she sees the missing finger, she knows she's dealing with Sam. And she knew that she should have taken care of Sam from before. So basically that's exactly what she says. This is my problem. Got to take care of this. So it looks like Vanessa's going to find some home in kicking Sam's ass. But Sam is hella strong, y'all. He's a really strong vampire. So it's going to be a really interesting fight in the next episode. Vanessa goes head to head with Sam, right? And I'm really wondering, is Vanessa going to stick around with these Johnsons? What happened to that ninja? We saw a little bit of ninja action from that ninja that's been very mysterious so far in the last episode that we saw. So that ninja's definitely tracking someone. That ninja's looking for someone. We don't know if it's a woman or a man. I'm leaning basically towards woman because we just lost Rebecca. So maybe we'll get another strong female character on the show. So that ninja's definitely looking for someone. Is she or he looking for that main vampire that we saw in the last seconds of the last episode? He looks like he's going to be definitely an old vampire. Or maybe he's a Van Helsing. We don't know. But maybe that ninja's searching for that vampire. Maybe that ninja's searching for Vanessa. We don't know yet. There was no clue in that, right? So Vanessa's basically going to face off against Sam. I think it's going to be a great episode, next episode, because these are two characters who I really enjoy watching. And both of them are very, very formidable in their own right. Can I just throw in really quickly that Sam kind of looked like the Joker? Did you guys see that? Is his makeup inspired by the Joker? And Vanessa just walked around with a big old blood smudge the whole episode. She doesn't give a damn, y'all. There was no mirrors anywhere. So in the next episode, we're going to see Sam and Vanessa go head to head. Hopefully, we see Axel and the doc finally arrive and Axel gets turned back to a human. That's what I'm looking forward to. And maybe we'll see Julius take a back seat to Axel. It's going to be interesting when Axel shows up because Julius and Axel, I think, are both kind of like in the same position where Axel's going to be hopefully turned back to a human. And I think they're both going to be aiming for that number one spot, that sidekick spot for Vanessa. So let's see what happens with that. So as always, guys, if you guys like what I do on this channel, make sure to hit the subscribe button. Make sure to hit the like button. Leave me a comment. Let me know what you guys thought about this episode. And as always, this is the Tone Show. Tone Show out.
Remember to like and subscribe for more Tone Show. Remember to like and subscribe for more Tone Show.